SpaceX team slowly prepare the first orbital-class Starship and Super Heavy booster. For the next-generation rockets, first full-stack launch, the company has simultaneously begun assembling a second ship booster pair. The latest prototype of Starship would be a great combination of Ship 21 and Booster 5. So what is the state of this prototype right now? What plans does SpaceX have for it, and how is it different from the previous prototypes? Let's find out. SpaceX appears to have delivered hardware that will eventually become part of the first 33-engine Super Heavy booster to its South Texas Starbase factory. Coming either from SpaceX's Hawthorne, California headquarters and Falcon rocket factory or a smaller fabrication shop, colocated on the company's McGregor, Texas development and testing campus. The giant coin-like structure was spotted arriving at Starbase on Tuesday afternoon. Unlike Falcon boosters, the latest variant of which relies on a structure known as an octaweb that's bolted together from dozens of structural elements, SpaceX has moved towards more monolithic thrust pucks for Starship and Super Heavy. Starship's central thrust puck is just 2 or so meters in diameter and designed to support the ship's 3 gimballing Raptor center engines. Super Heavy's puck is actually more like a giant steel coin than Starship's almost conical thrust structure, measuring some 5 to 6 meters, 16 to 20 feet across, but no more than a few inches, approximately 10 centimeters thick. It's also designed to support a good deal more than 3 Raptors. That's where Tuesday's deliver becomes significant. Unlike older booster thrust pucks, one of which was actually delivered to Starbase likely for Super Heavy B5, or B6 just last week, this newer puck features a few design changes. Most importantly, it bumps the number of Raptor center engine hardpoints to 13. Slightly earlier instances, including the puck currently packed with Raptors on Super Heavy Booster 4, have an outer circle of 8 Raptors and a 9th engine at the very center. According to Musk, though, SpaceX might not have to wait long to find out just how viable a recovery method Mechazilla really is and will, hopefully, attempt to catch Super Heavy Booster 5 after Starship's second orbital launch attempt. Presumably, that attempt is contingent upon FAA approval and on Booster 4 successfully simulating a smooth, accurate landing in the Gulf, as even a minor issue during a catch attempt could catastrophically damage pad hardware that would take months to repair or replace. For now, it's almost impossible to say when Starship S-20 and Super Heavy B-4 will be ready for their orbital launch debut, as that now lies almost solely in the hands of the FAA. In theory, the FAA could complete environmental reviews and grant SpaceX a launch license, as few as 2 or so months from now. In practice, SpaceX could be forced to sit and wait for at least 2 to 3 more months for first orbital launch attempt. Regardless, SpaceX has already begun assembling and staging sections of Ship 21 and Booster 5, so the company could be ready for an extremely rapid turnaround in Mechazilla's first catch attempt, after Starship's orbital launch debut, whenever that may come. In line with comments made by CEO Elon Musk in early July, SpaceX's newest Super Heavy thrust puck updates both figures, boosting the outer ring to 10 engines and inner cluster to 3 engines, for a total of 13 Raptors. Combined with a ring of 20 fixed Raptor boost engines installed on the inside of Super Heavy's aft skirt, a 13-engine puck will allow SpaceX to install up to 33 engines on Super Heavy boosters. Using present-day first-generation Raptor 1 engines, a Super Heavy booster with 33 engines installed could produce up to 6,100 tons, approximately 13.5 million pound of thrust at liftoff. Once SpaceX has qualified and ramped up production of next-generation Raptor 2 engines, Super Heavy's max thrust at liftoff could jump to almost 7,600 tons, approximately 16.8 million pound, more than twice that of the current record holder, NASA's famous Saturn B moon rocket. Given that the puck delivered on October 5 appears to be the first of its kind, there's a decent chance that it will end up not on the first 33-engine Super Heavy, but on a small test tank designed to qualify its structural changes. However, even if that's the case, the next flight-grade 13-engine thrust puck will likely arrive at Starbase in just a month or two, when SpaceX sets its sights on the assembly of that first 33-engine booster. SpaceX will be juggling 2 pairs of orbital-class Starships and Super Heavy boosters. Now, the important question is, what is the difference between this new Starship and the couple Ship 20 Booster 4? The first thing, the Raptor engines a few months ago, Elon Musk shared on Twitter the 29 Raptor on booster initially rising to 33 later this year, along with thrust increase per engine, aiming for above 7,500 ton thrust, long-term thruster weight ratio around 1.5. So we hope that Booster 5 will be the first prototype that has 33 Raptors. In the next plan, SpaceX may aim to use a new Raptor prototype, which is Raptor 2.0. Raptor 2.0 is the post-iterative development version of Raptor, in September of 2019. SpaceX stated their current plan was to use Raptor 2, for the 3C-level engines on the Starship second stage, and also for all booster engines, both those that gimbal and those that do not. On the Super Heavy first stage, they don't have a cover, they're out in the open. In addition, by removing the last two rings of the engine section, you can save a lot of weight, and more importantly, Raptor engines appear to be able to handle the heat, which might be the reason they don't need the engine cover. This prototype promises to bring the most optimal values of propulsion. In addition, it has simpler pipes. This is another reason to reduce complexity and weight. These engines will eventually be produced at SpaceX's new engine development facility, near McGregor, Texas, announced in July of 2021. The second thing, the flaps. Elon Musk last month confirmed that upcoming versions of Starship, including Ship 21, will have slightly smaller flaps, with the aerodynamic cowling ahead of the flaps being adjusted to optimize for re-entry. We can see it in the latest render versions. It also seems to more realistically represent thermal protection. The leeward side of the flaps is no longer entirely covered in the black thermal protection. The third thing, SN21 seems to have a different attachment technique of TPS tiles, maybe better than Ship 20. CEO Elon Musk says that SpaceX could attempt to catch a Super Heavy booster out of midair with a tower-sized Mechazilla robot as early as Starship's second orbital launch attempt. SpaceX installed said Starship launch tower's first arms, in a move that can be only described as unexpected. SpaceX revealed plans to fully expend its first orbital-class Starship and Super Heavy booster pair in May 2021. FCC filings, confirming, or strongly implying, that no true recovery attempts would be made. Instead, in what could be described as a quasi-orbital debut, SpaceX intends to launch the first two-stage Starship to an altitude of around 200 to 300 km, during first orbital launch debut. Like many Falcon boosters, Super Heavy will separate a few minutes after liftoff, flip around, and boost back towards the South Texas coast, where it will attempt a soft landing 20 miles offshore in the Gulf of Mexico. Reading between the lines of Musk's latest info, depending on the results of that ocean landing attempt, SpaceX might attempt to catch the second flight-worthy Super Heavy Booster 5 on the very next launch. No different than a hypothetical landing with legs, Super Heavy will still have to boost back to land, coast, and fire up several Raptor engines for a final landing burn. Only on tiny handle-like hardpoints and giant moving arms instead of legs in a concrete pad. If catching boosters eventually proves reliable enough to be a worthwhile reinvention of the wheel, the only apparent benefit of the approach will be a slight reduction in Super Heavy's dry mass. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.